टेस्ट नंबर 19 पार्ट 1 सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 46। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 46 व्हाट इज गिवन देयर व्हेन एसिफाइड सॉल्यूशन ऑफ फेरस अमोनियम सल्फेट रिएक्ट्स विद KMnO4। एज वी नो KMnO4 एक्ट्स एज एन स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट। KMnO4 एक्ट्स एज एन स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट। सो इन एसिडिक मीडियम MnO4- get reduce itself to Mn2+, while ferrous ion Fe2+ gets oxidized into Fe3+. So ferrous ion will oxidize into ferric ion by KMnO4 in acidic medium. So the ion which is oxidized is ferrous ion. Question number 46, option C is correct. See question number 47. Question number 47, what is given there? Question number 47. The protection of steel by chrome. Protection of steel by chrome. By chrome is due to, as we know that cathodic protection technique. This is the technique used to control the corrosion of metal. So basically cathodic protection technique is used to control the corrosion of metal by making it cathode. So this is the process we use in the production of steel by chrome. So question number 47, option A is correct. See question number 48. In question number 48, what is given there? Question number 48. Reaction of zinc with cold and very dilute HNO3. Very dilute HNO3. When very dilute HNO3 is used, then ammonium nitrate will form. So when zinc reacts with very dilute HNO3, then it forms zinc nitrate along with ammonium nitrate plus water. So question number 47, option 48, option C is correct. See question number 49. In question number 49, what is given? Out of the ions. Question number 48. As we can see that Zn2+ configuration will be argon 3d10. So all electrons are paired. Therefore it is diamagnetic. When it is diamagnetic means colorless. While Ni2+ and Cr3+ contains unpaired electron. So due to unpaired electron, it is paramagnetic, and paramagnetic is responsible for color. So Zn2+ is diamagnetic, which is colorless, while Ni2+ and Cr3+ are colored. So question number 49, option A is correct. See question number 50. In question number 50, what is given there? Question number 50. The question is, identify the reaction that does not take place during the smelting process. As we know, in a smelting process, the reaction in a smelting process takes place are copper sulfide plus O2, sulfide ore gas converted into Cu2O plus SO2. Also, iron sulfide also changes into iron oxide plus SO2. And the impurity, that is basic impurity, when added with acidic flux, it forms slag. So basically these reaction takes place in a smelting process. So the reaction which does not take place in copper extraction, this reaction which is given in option B, द रिएक्शन विच इज गिवन इन ऑप्शन बी डज नॉट हैपन ड्यूरिंग एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ कॉपर. सो दिस रिएक्शन इज नॉट हैपन ड्यूरिंग द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ कॉपर इन ए स्मेल्टिंग प्रोसेस. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 50 ऑप्शन बी इज करेक्ट. चेंज द ऑप्शन सी इज करेक्ट बट ऑप्शन बी इज नॉट करेक्ट. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 50 ऑप्शन बी. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 51. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 व्हाट इज गिवन देयर. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एग्जिबिट मैक्सिमम ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ वैनेडियम. मैक्सिमम ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ वैनेडियम एज वी कैन सी दैट इन वी ओ सी एल थ्री लेट वी एज एक्स ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑक्सीजन इज माइनस टू एंड क्लोरिन इज माइनस वन. सो इट इज इक्वल टू सो एक्स विल कम आल्सो प्लस फाइव. सो मैक्सिमम ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ वी ओ सी एल थ्री. तो क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 52. क्वेश्चन नंबर 52 व्हाट इज गिवन देयर. एज वी नो इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 52 ऑल नाइट्रेट्स आर सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. ऑल नाइट्रेट्स आर सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. सो ऑल नाइट्रेट्स आर सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. सिमिलरली ऑल क्लोराइड्स आर सोल्यूबल इन वाटर. ऑल क्लोराइड्स आर सोल्यूबल इन वाटर एक्सेप्ट कॉपर फर्स्ट क्लोराइड लेड सेकेंड एंड मर्करी फर्स्ट. ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर दीज आर दी. सो कॉपर प्लस वन क्लोराइड लेड प्लस टू एंड मर्करी प्लस वन दैट इज एच जी टू टू प्लस मर्क्यूरस आयन. So, as per the question, the compound insoluble in water, the form by Hg2 plus chloride is mercurous chloride. That is mercurous chloride. So, question number 52, option C is correct. See question number 54. In question number 54, what is given there? See, in question number 54, magnetic moment is expressed in. As we know that the formula of magnetic moment is under root of n into n plus 2 and unit is Bohr magneton. And unit is Bohr magneton where n is number of unpaired electrons. So question number 54, magnetic moment is expressed in Bohr magneton. Bohr magneton is the unit of magnetic moment. So question number 54, option C is correct. See question number 55. In question number 55, what is given there? The question is a group of acidic oxides is. As we know that when CrO3 reacts with water, it forms chromic acid. Similarly, when Mn2O7 reacts with water, it forms HMnO4 that is permanganic acid. So when these oxides react with water form acids, therefore these two oxides are acidic oxides CrO3 and Mn2O7. So question number 55 option A is correct. See question number 56. In question number 56, what is given there? Question is, zinc and mercury belong to same group and they differ in many properties. The property that is shared by both, as we know that both zinc and mercury form oxides radially. For example, like zinc oxide, mercury oxide, they radially form oxides. So this property is common for both. Question number 56, option A is correct. See question number 57. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 57 व्हाट इज गिवन देयर, सी इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 57 द क्वेश्चन इज वन ऑफ द कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ जर्मन सिल्वर, जर्मन सिल्वर. सो देयर इज ऑलवेज मिथ एज इट जर्मन सिल्वर, वाइल द कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ जर्मन सिल्वर आर इट कंटेन्स कॉपर 60% एंड जिंक 20% एंड निकेल 20%. सो पीपल विल थिंक इट इज जर्मन सिल्वर सो इट विल कंटेन सिल्वर, वाइट इट्स कंस्टिट्यूएंट डज नॉट कंटेन एनी सिल्वर, इट कंटेन्स कॉपर जिंक एंड निकेल. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 57 वन ऑफ द कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ जर्मन सिल्वर इज कॉपर इन द गिवन ऑप्शन, सो ऑप्शन बी इज करेक्ट. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 58 इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 58 व्हाट इज गिवन, द क्वेश्चन इज मेटल हैविंग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6 3d10 4s1. As we can see that this is 18 and 10 28 and 29. So Z is 29. The element basically is copper and copper is 3d series element. So copper is basically d block element and also last electron entered in the d orbital, so it is basically a d block element. Question number 58, option B is correct. See question number 59. In question number 59 what is given there, see in question number 59 the question is which of the following statement is not true, which of the following statement is not true regarding the transition element, transition element. See, as we know that the given statement in all their ions are colorless, as we know 90% transition elements are colored, 90% transition elements are colored due to unpaired electron, due to unpaired electron, and only few are colorless, and only few are colorless. So basically question number 59, all their ions are colorless in general, correct, all their ions are colorless is not true statement. 90% of their elements are colored due to unpaired electron and only few are colorless. So question number 59, option C is correct. See question number 60. In question number 60 what is given there, the question is question number 60 for making silver from silver nitrate which of the following is used. As we know that when AgNO3 is heated it gives Ag plus NO2 and plus O2. So basically for making silver from AgNO3 we provide a atmosphere of gas that is phosphine. So question number 60, option A is correct.